Hello everyone, today I'm going to talk about a magnesium supplement, magnesium oxide. For many people who want to try magnesium supplement, after some search on the internet, they will skip magnesium oxide first. Because they see this, and more 4% absorption thing in the internet articles. It seems very stupid to buy magnesium oxide. As a scientist, I was very surprised to see so much criticism on magnesium oxide. So I dig into the research paper cited in those internet articles. As a result, the 4% story of magnesium oxide is completely misleading. On the contrary, magnesium oxide is good to most of the people as a magnesium supplement. The 4% number is from a research paper in 2001. Scientists measured urinary magnesium excretion in normal volunteers taking different salt form magnesium supplements. They claim as this. Results indicated relatively poor bioavailability of magnesium oxide, fractional absorption 4%. But significantly higher and equivalent bioavailability of magnesium chloride, magnesium lactate, and magnesium aspartate. You might wonder what the exact bioavailability is for these three very soluble magnesium salts in their experiment. It is weird that these numbers are never shown in any internet articles. Let me tell you, based on the data, from this paper, magnesium chloride, magnesium lactate, and magnesium aspartate has a bioavailability 13%, 12%, and 10% respectively. The magnesium lactate and magnesium aspartate are so-called magnesium organic ketate. The I9 here is lactic acid and aspartic acid. Other popular magnesium organic chelates include magnesium citrate and magnesium glycinate. These magnesium salts are completely dissolvable and share very similar physical properties. From the data, we see magnesium organic chelates have higher bioavailability than magnesium oxide. It is good enough to trash magnesium oxide, isn't it? No. There is a huge difference in elemental magnesium content between magnesium oxide and these magnesium organic chelates. The magnesium content is 60% in magnesium oxide, 14% in magnesium glycinate, 12% in magnesium lactate, 11% in magnesium citrate, and 8% in magnesium aspartate. Let's do a simple calculation based on the data from the paper above. If I take 500 mg magnesium oxide with a 4% absorption, the elemental magnesium I absorb is 500 mg times 60% times 4%. I will get 12 mg elemental magnesium. We do the same calculation for 500 mg magnesium lactate with 12% absorption. I will absorb 7.2 mg magnesium. For 500 mg magnesium aspartate, I will only get 4 mg magnesium. We can clearly see the much higher magnesium content in magnesium oxide compensate its poor bioavailability. As a result, you will absorb as much magnesium, if not more, from magnesium oxide. There is no reason to blame the poor bioavailability of it. Comparing to other similar research, this 2001 paper shows a bioavailability number in lower side, but the trend is the same. Magnesium organic chelates have higher bioavailability, but magnesium oxide is at least as effective, if not better, at restoring and maintaining a healthy level of magnesium. You probably ask, if magnesium oxide is good, why it is not working as good as magnesium glycinate to me. Okay, it is good for you to find magnesium glycinate working. Trust me, there are other people challenging magnesium glycinate or magnesium citrate by the same question. It's kind of like a herbal medicine. You will not know it works or not until you try it. I will suggest you give a try for different salts, at least 2 weeks each. If more than one works, choose the cheaper one. At last, I want to remind, there are hype and misleading in the supplement market. It is necessary to do some research before you buy. If you don't want to do that, just let me know. I can help. This is all I have today. Again, thanks for your time. If you like my video, please click the like button and subscribe to my channel.